So once again, I request all the participants to make use of the available time with the resource person and clarify doubts if any needed. And let me introduce the today's resource person, that is Dr. M. Sandeep Kumar. Sir has completed his BTech from Maharashtra College of Engineering and then MTech from NIT Calicut 2010, PhD from NIT Bangalore 2016. And his fields of specialization includes nanotechnology, machining, eco-friendly cutting fluids, manufacturing technology. And sir has published nearly 17 publications and then one patent. And to his achievements, he has received Best Paper Award at a conference, International Conference on Applied Mechanical Engineering Research 2019 held at NIT Warangal. And his research GATE score is 6.29, Google Scholar Citations is 124, and H index is 5, I10 index is 4. And we both have initiated this STDP program and is my co-host also. So with this introduction, I request Dr. M. Sandeep Kumar to start the session.
A very good afternoon to all the participants. I thank Dr. Varun, my colleague, and you can call him as an organizer, right? So he is the first person who was here to start up these things, and now sir has given me as a host, so let me share my screen and then we can move.
Yes, sir. Start your screen.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, a very good afternoon to all the participants and a very happy new year to each and everyone who has participated. So it's an end of 2020 and I hope everyone is expecting something new. Last time it was like every day we had a disaster happening here, hearing this and hearing that everywhere. Yeah, I hope this 2021 brings good news to each and everyone. Okay, so coming to the today's session, our guru P.B. Dhanasar was there in the first session, and myself and Dr. Varun, who is the organizer of this STTP, we were trained under him when we were having our post-graduation under him. But things have changed. It was past 10 years before we were under him. Okay. Yeah. So the whole idea of doing this STTP, I would just wanted to brief you down first. The whole idea of doing this STTP or applying for this STTP for AICTE was the thing that what we have faced problems from the last 10 to 12 years. Like each and everyone knows it. Some people are aware of DOE, some people are not aware of DOE. Why DOE is there, and many things are there which actually when we interact with men, most of the people in our career, we came across some difficulties. Some people still don't want to go through DOE. Some of the good laboratories are the recognized laboratories in India are there. Those who still follow a normal technique or normal experimental plans, what we generally follow. And they are actually, when we also like compare, right, when compared to the previous things, and now when we compare to the present trend or the advantages of DOE, design of experiments and all these things, yes, there is a difference. Sometimes some kind of experiments will be there which we can't fit in DOE, and so that's why we follow some general methods, or sometimes when we have some provision to do it, yes, we generally follow design of experiments. And yes, it has some advantages, that's why still it is going on and still people are using it, and there are some advantages that we'll be looking through actually. Okay. Yeah. So coming to the registration details, guys, we had from all the branches. Yeah, it's actually, this slide actually fascinates me. Yeah, you may be seeing here like mechanical, you know, around 65.4. Yes, because the branch which is hosting this STTP is mechanical. So I am finding this. But yes, frankly speaking, DOE is for each and every one, not only for mechanical. Each and every field of engineering, and apart from that, you can see medical, pharmaceuticals, management, and all other these fields. So DOE is for everyone. So like DOE is one tool which actually gives you a systematic way of doing experimentation and knowing the impact. Actually, you will be having many inputs for a response. So once you get these inputs, and you will be knowing what input actually is influencing the output more, influencing the output more. So that all things we can do with DOE, and this is just a simple tool which aids us in getting the data or the influence, which parameters is influencing and how much is it influencing. So these are all the details, so that at least you will only consider that parameters. So if you see, if you take some any output, there are n number of factors which are actually affecting that output. So with using all these DOE tools, and there are n number of techniques which we'll be looking into from tomorrow onwards. Today it was just an introduction, and now it is like walkthrough. But yeah, so there'll be n number of techniques, like one factor at a time, full factorial, fractional factorial is there. Then you have RSM, response surface methodologies, all. There are many techniques. So we will this whole STTP will be concentrating on looking into which technique would suit your requirements, and apart from that, we'll be having discussion sessions also, and the resource persons will be giving you how apt it is for your problem. So with this, I would like to see that, yes, this I would like to brief down finally that, yes, this DOE, this STTP session would be like concentrating on all the beginners who don't know why we need to use DOE. Apart from that, all the sessions will be in such a way that you can know actually, right, if you have a problem, which kind of technique I can use to fit my data into it, and then I can just use that data, okay, so I'll get some output. So it is, it's this STTP will be covering all these things. So with this, these are some of the colleges, participants from many of the colleges from throughout India. So this was a stat given by Dr. Varun, and like we were looking into, we are reaching. The target was like we should reach throughout India, and that is what is happening. And apart from that, many of the cities, like we can find it here. Like from now, if you see from, yes, from here we are there. Apart from that, Allahabad is there, Mumbai is there, yeah, Bhopal is there, Mandya is there, Karad, Maharashtra. Yeah, so we are having participants from all over the country. So now with this, actually, as I told you, STTP focuses on participants who are beginners. First thing is, the major issue is everyone is good at research, and they know all the techniques and all the everything. They are good at they are up to date at research. But the only thing is, what at the final stage? Yes, we too had the same thing when we were doing our research work. We are going through our research work. Everything we knew, but the only thing is, where can we fit this? So how can we, which design should I use, where can I fit it, can it be applicable, or what should be considered, and this all things will come up. Or how can I use this DOE tool also is a very important aspect. And knowing it, if you know it, it is a very simple aspect, tool. Okay. So with this, I would request all the participants to first at least install the link which our coordinator has forwarded you in the WhatsApp group. So I hope each and every participants have downloaded the software which has been forwarded to you through the WhatsApp group. Yes, yeah, some time will be given to you for the participants, so that you can download this file and you can install it. So once that is done, I will go to the installation procedure. The only, as I told you, the aim of this HTTP is to see that each and every participant who has joined this session should be comfortable in using DOE. Apart from that, the participant should be familiar with each and every tool or a method which is being used. So for that, this is the most important step. So I expect each and every participant will download this DOE software. It is a trial version software. With the link is for the trial version one. We'll be giving you 5 minutes for this, if the net speed is okay. And if it's net speed is okay, we'll be giving you 5 minutes. Please try to download it, and we'll make sure that you'll be comfortable with using this software. Yes, dear participants, if you have already installed, please you can raise your hands so that at least we can know and we can concentrate on the other part of the sessions.
So, dear participants, if you have already installed, you can type that in the chat window. Or you need any assistance also, you can inform the same in the chat window so that we can assist you. Once you got installation completed, then we can walk you through the sequence of steps on how to decide the design. And when we introduce different designs like RSM, factorial design, Taguchi, you will get familiarized and you can practice on your own. So this step is very important. So please, you can be installed in Ubuntu. Yes, you can install in Ubuntu, sir. You need to do is in the same website. There is a option for installation in Windows, Mac, or even open source softwares like Ubuntu. If any such doubts are there, please you can type in the chat window so we can come to know exactly and we can address the issue. Installing software. Okay, sir. So once the installation is done, please let us know. Yeah, 32-bit OS also is available. And that should not be any problem.
Yeah, dear participants, apart from this installation, actually in the WhatsApp group, sir has forwarded you a PPT, which would actually guide you, a PPT or PDF file document, which would actually guide you through installation also. So if you have already downloaded, you can follow that procedure, or else in next 2 minutes, we'll be sliding through that PPT. dear participants, I hope all of you have downloaded at least the setup file. And now let us browse through some of the steps for installation. So once we have gone through the status and there the request, like you click on this and then we'll be having the URL what we have sent in the WhatsApp group and request for demo for your team. And there you have to mention the step three is like you have to mention your mail IDs and you can give your password. Means in short, you want to register, you have to register. So once you fill out all the details required, then you can, this detail will ask that I'm not a robot fan. So it has to be done. Once that is done, you have to register. Once that step is over, then you have to check your email ID and click on the information which is given in the email for the 30 days trial version. And we need to confirm your profile. Exactly, right? So after confirming, click on software tab as shown here and click on free trial. So once that thing is done, you need to give the details and again you have to request. Once that is done, again we had a doubt, right? We can go for 32 bit or 64 bit, anyone, like any one of this, or Mac OS and all these things, you can go through it. After that, after download, the installation tab will start and you'll be having the next tab here. Then you can save wherever you want to keep this in the program file. If you want to install in some other drive also, you can do it. Once that thing is done, click on the install tab. Then the status will take some 5 to 10 minutes for installation. We had only 5 minutes, but fine. If everyone has installed, it is good actually for us. 5 to 10 minutes it will take generally. And you can finish it. Once that thing is done, you can just run as an administrator. Then click on the accept tab. Then check your mail. You'll be getting some serial number for this thing. So once that thing is there, you just keep the serial number in this tab and then you should okay. Yeah, then you can click on register online. So once that is there, fill in the required details and click on register license. Right. So finally, once that thing is done, you will be getting this window, which says that it is a trial version. Okay, so these are the, some of the simplest steps required for installation. So I hope each and every participant has installed the DOE software. Now, let us come today to the slide or the time where we have to start introducing design of experiments. Yeah, so why we need design of experiments? There is actually a very big cat fight actually in between researchers or academicians, or if you see research laboratories even. Why do we use DOE? Why? Simply we can do some experimentations, right? I will have some X factors and Y factors, depending on that I'll be getting some output as Z. Fine. I'll do this. That is fine. That normally everyone does it, right? In our laboratories also, we do the same thing. Many of the experimentations, what we do in our laboratories also, we do the same way. I have some X values, some inputs. With that inputs, I'll be getting some outputs. Yes, then why you need DOE? I'll ask you one question. Can you say particular X factor or some Y factor, how much, which is the most influence factor between the two? Yes. Yeah. Let us go slow. And I don't know how many of you are beginners. So I hope this session will be concentrating on the beginners only. So that is what I would be looking into. Okay. So we have some X, we have some Y, and we are looking into something called Z. This is our input. This is also our input, and we are having some output here. Yeah. So most of the experimental laboratory experimenters will be only concentrating on this kind of things. Yes. Yeah, fine. We get some results. That is still, till that extent is okay. But where DOE plays a role is, how much is X influencing Z? Or how much is Y influencing Z? Can we know this? It's a very difficult task. I can't know actually how much is it influencing, what percentage is it influencing. I don't know. Or can I know that which value of X and which value of Y I'll be getting a better Z? which combination of X and Y's will be I'll be getting a better Z or output. It's a very difficult task to know actually. So here comes actually DOE. So DOE actually is a systematic experimentation plan which gives you the influence of the input parameters to the output parameters. Apart from that, we get some regression equations which can further go into the range where you can predict even the output. Okay, so that is the main importance of DOE. So with this, let us start how actually DOE was there in the previous decades and now how it is. Like, if you see the applications of DOE in scientific research, when you see initially from 1990s, it was like around 20,000 publications were only there, which were dependent on DOE, 20,000 publications only. Then within the next decade, it rose to around 40,000. So almost multiplied by two. Then in the next decade, if you see somewhere it is reaching around 70,000 or 40,000 to 70,000, it has reached up. And still in this region, from the last one decade, if you can see the amount of publications, how people, means how many papers are being published using DOE. Excuse me. So what does this stat indicate is that the application of DOE is going on increasing, and apart from that, researchers are more interested in getting the data actually. Same data, or say if I, you can say in laboratory experiments, yes, naturally I get a data, but what kind of results are you getting out of that data is the most important aspect for us. Or how much are you interpreting? Right. Yes, data getting is some moment of time you can get some data, but what is that you're interpreting from that data, and how much are you gaining from that data or extracting from the data is more important for us. So that is why nowadays, after awareness of this DOE, publications have gone increasing nowadays. Apart from that, you have some progressive use of DOE as scientific method over the past two decades. So you can see this from the past two decades, they are saying that they have done this in R-square, it means in NO method only, and you can see the R-square is like 0.97, so around 97% there is a growth, and keep it in mind, and we'll be going through when we look into ANOVA and the other things of this other sessions of this STTP, we'll be knowing why it is this point is very important for us. And now the last slide for introductions is like applications of DOE into scientific areas. So if you see, only we were engineers and we just concentrated on this part of it, right? So how many of us have used DOE? Something around 10% of us have only used it. But if you see in the medical field also, it is 18%. So that is what, when we were in the starting slide, when I was saying that slide actually fascinated me, was like not only engineers, many other you can say areas of research are there which actually concentrate more. And if you see medical, yes, most, yes, this actually DOE is a statistical tool developed by mathematicians, but still engineers are using it mostly for their output. And apart from that, see where medical is standing with us, right? So you can see it's around using twice the time for us, right? So it's around 80%, 18% they are using this for out of the total. So you can see that DOE is a tool which can be used throughout, like for all the streams of education and research. And it gives actually a very important output or a very important interpretation from the data what we get. So that is what was our main intention. It's not only this STTP is not only concentrating on the engineers or the other thing, but it is a generalized. So that is why we are trying to see that we generalize things. So with this, let us start with the design of experiments. So what is design of experiments? It is a branch of statistics, okay, which is actually used for planning, conducting, analyzing, and interpreting controlled tests to evaluate the factors that control the value of a parameter or a group of parameters. So usually what we do is we have some factors. These are called as input factors, or we call it in some terms, we call it as variables. So with this, we have some levels also. We need to set some levels for the inputs, and we are checking for output. This is a general procedure how we do it for general experimentation data also. We do the same thing. But when it comes to DOE, we try to extract more, or we try to analyze. Yes, conduct planning and conducting, we usually do it. But what we extra do it, we analyze it, we interpret the control test to evaluate the factors that control the value for a parameter or a group of parameters. So it is important to obtain maximum realistic information with minimum number of well-designed experiments. So what happens is with DOE, the major advantage, okay, one again, which comes here is most of us, like nowadays, if you see, some experiments are very costly. Some experiments are very good enough to do it. Some experiments are difficult to do. Some experiments are, like you can say, very easy to do or very difficult to do sometimes. Or some experiments are time consuming. Some are okay. You can do it within some minutes. So usually what happens is DOE tries to fit all these parameters with us, right? So if I can't afford to do many experiments, or the experiment is too costly, then I can select some design which will give me output with a very less number of input. Okay, apart from that, if I have huge number of data, then I can interpret the data in a very good way, and I can extract more of an realistic outputs. So apart from that, what he is saying is that with minimum number of experimentations number of data, then too I can get some realistic information as a thing. Apart from that, an experimental program recognizes the major factors. So the factors which are affecting the output, they are recognized here. And apart from that, not only it recognizes, but it will see how much it is impacting or how much is its influence on the output. Next, the factor may be identified by looking at all the quantities that may affect the outcome of the experiment. So basically, it interprets which factor is more important and how much is it important or what is its influence on the data. So the most important among this may be identified using the exploratory experiments or from past experience or based on some underlying theory or hypothesis. So basically, we generally what we do is, if we are some skilled operators or skilled researchers, what we do is we get some data from the you can call it as publications or literature review and all these things, or some we do it through our own experiences, or we use some underlying theories like theories or hypotheses to get this data. Yeah, so this is why we have some importance of DOE. So what happens here is, let us start now how basically DOE has to be done. The selection process is not, selecting of this process is known as DOE, but what should we do when we have to conduct experiments? Yes. So the first and foremost factor is the response or an output. So we need to know, yes, I know why I'm doing an experiment. If I'm doing some tensile testing, I know that when a rod has been put in UTM, or fixed in UTM jaws, and then I'm pulling it, I know that I am trying for, or I'm searching for the tensile strength of that material. I know that I'm looking for the tensile strength, that is the output. Then what would be my input? It would be like material properties. It would be the dimensions of the job, right? What kind of material I am using. So these are some of the inputs. So the first and foremost thing is I need to know what response I am looking for. Okay. So once I look into what response I am looking for, then I need to know what are the factors that are influencing the response. Once I know these things, then further we have some steps. So for understanding of this, I will be taking a small, very common example for each and every one, so that you can understand what I am speaking about, like output, response, factors, and all these things. So let us take a small example so that you can understand that, the thing. Yeah. So the small example, I don't know how many of you heard of it, and we have a famous ads, right? Whenever we switch on the TVs, we are all Indians are fond of mileage, or kitna deti hai, this is a famous thing that each and every time we switch on the TV, even for ships and the yachts also, we ask them how much, what is the mileage. So, and each and every car manufacturers and all this, now they are like Maruti's and all this, just they only concentrate on this aspect, the mileage. So this is the most important aspect. So I thought that we will be connecting better for this. So yes, let us like a glance about it. Yes, so mileage is the most important aspect. Now, if you see, the fuel prices in the petrol is going around 87 to 80, 88 rupees a liter. Then it's a very difficult task for each and everyone to what should I do with this rising prices, right? So there it's like if you take Kitna Diti was the first thing. So let us be like, I hope each and everyone is a middle-aged guy here, middle-aged participant here, or maybe young guys. So always there is a mile. So for us, it's like if you see, like having a first bike is always a good thing. And there are wide range. Indians are fond of bikes. And nowadays, yes, the trend is shifting towards cars, but still, in India, the first preference or the first vehicle a person would be buying would be a bike. So they are all different categories of bike which are available in the market, and like from ranging from 100cc to with 350cc, which normal a person can afford in India. So we have, if you see, the mileage king of Indian roads is like Splendor, and every family man's desire is first thing is Splendor, because he has to be light on his pocket and he has to save some money for his family. The second would be like, if you are a youth option, right? So the first option for a youth is like an Pulsar. Yeah, I suppose nowadays, yes, it has changed a bit, yes, but still it is a 150cc vehicle. I assume everyone is okay with 150cc. I didn't consider Enfield, because I didn't want any much difference between the first option and the second option for us. Yeah, so again, we had this out of Kitna Deti Hai, what is this mileage, man? I'm spending so much of money behind bikes, that is lakh and something, and how much I'm getting an output from that. So always it is a $1 million question. Which one is suitable for us? Yeah, you may be asking me, sir, what is this? What kind of example we are going into? But yeah, this is a very important aspect when it comes to understanding of BOE. So which option should I go? Should I go for the first option, which gives me good mileage and I am saving, it is less on my, less depth, less on my pockets will be good enough. If I go for the second one, yes, naturally there isn't much difference in the bike prices. Yes, 10 to 15, 20,000 there is there, but for a middle, what you can say is for a normal human being, yes, normal Indian, yes, this again, it matters actually, because buying a bike is only one time approach, but they are like, if you like using it and refilling your tank is a daily approach, short term or long term, that depends on us, right? So this is the question what we have wanted to solve through DOE. I just gave some word like yes, if it is for a kid, mom would love to give his kid like an Pulsar or something, and if it's a dad, he wants a smaller pocket, so he will trying to prefer an Splendor, and that's it. So who will win out of this? This is where I would like to come up. Who will win out of this? And I would like to see who can come out of this with and what should I consider? What should I consider? The first thing was mileage, right? My output wasn't mileage. So what I'll be looking is how much mileage would I achieve from the first option or second option. Mileage is my output, that is fine. But on what factors is a major issue, okay? What factors I am judging this output? So what I'll do is I'll take some three factors. First is number of persons who are riding. So if I say number of persons who are riding, I can take one person and two persons, right? Generally, as per the government norms also, we can go single rider or with a pillion. As third person I can't take, because it's out of rule here. So I've taken number of persons as 1 and 2. Okay, names of the bikes, what I did is cubic capacity of an engine. So the first option had cubic capacity of an engine 100, the other one is 150 cc, cubic capacity. Then at what average speed do I travel daily? Some people travel at 50, some people travel at 70. So these are some of the factors actually which I thought of that would influence the performance or the mileage of these two options what I have in the market. Yeah. So final thing is kitna detiye, this is my response. So these were the factors, these were the levels at which these factors are, and we had a response means kitna detiye, what would be the mileage of my bike. I want to know actually which one should I buy, right? It's a very tricky question. Let us see. Mileage. Yeah. So I would request the participants who are here to just can they tell me this time? I request the participants to just please vote actually. Right? What do you think? Which factor would influence my output, that is mileage, the more? Dear participants, as poll has been posted actually, like please can if anyone tell me which actually is the factor which influence the mileage more. Yeah, we have around 41% voting, 47, 53. Yes, participants, please. Out of 19, only 53 means only around 9 participants have voted here. Dear participants, because as we have some might, this DOE actually removes that might which we have, right? Should we use DOE? Is it useful for us? Or how far can we interpret the data? And all these things will come out actually. Please vote. We are not giving any marks. We don't know actually who has voted for which response, sorry, which factor. So only 10 participants have voted. Yeah, dear participants, once again I'm requesting you to please vote, at least vote, okay? Or is there any difficulty for voting, like if you are not comfortable with or we don't know where to use this poll? Yeah, so already almost 4 minutes we have waited, and I hope I'm ending the poll here. Thank you, should I end? Yes, coordinator, should I end? Okay. Okay. Yeah, some messages are there. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So, participants actually like. Oh, yeah. So, as this poll, the thing behind getting the poll results is usually it was like reading your minds. Generally, we think of something, it happens something. So, you generally what we say is something, and what happens is something, because each and everything can't be explained scientifically. And yes, sometimes we have to do it scientifically. And if we sit behind that and do all these things, it will be time consuming thing. Yes. So, we are also viewing. Actually gives us, aids us to check this. Yes, this data what we had already procured now from the poll what we had will be exhibited tomorrow when we look into the full factorial or fractional factorial designs tomorrow afternoon session what we'll be having it. So after that we can look into that. Yes. Yeah. So let us start with some of the terminology of this, which actually are important for us in design of experiments. So why I gave this example is so that you can know actually what kind of thing or what is most important thing or how should you start a designing particular. Okay, the first thing is response variable. So what is response variable? The response variable is a measured output value. For us, the measured output value was mileage. I was concentrating on only mileage. What I need is that with minimum amount of fuel, how much can be the output or what could be the maximum output that I can get. So for me, it was the mileage. Okay. Next, factors. What were the factors or what were the input variable that can be changed? So what were the factors that I could have considered? For time being or for my convenience, I considered only three factors which I thought was influential. Yes, there may be many factors like road conditions were there. Okay, but I had considered only three factors. What were the three factors? First one was number of persons traveling on a bike. The second one was capacity of an engine. The third one was average speed at what I am traveling. Yes, but apart from this, there will be many factors which actually could be influential. But as I had a normal experience with the bikes, I just thought of that these three factors are okay, important for us. Yes, if you don't have that knowledge, that clear knowledge for particularly selecting what factors are influential, then you have to consider all the factors and then you have to go on checking which is most influential. Once you know these factors are most influential, for that factors only you need to consider the for experimentation. Okay, so most of us, what we do is, yes, most of us are mechanical engineers. Let us discuss with some of the machining parameters. So if you see the n number of factors which would be affecting the machining parameters, but what we say is in general that speed, feed and depth of cut are the three principal parameters which affect the machining, right? Speed, feed and depth of cut are the three influencing factors. That is what we say in general. Apart from that, there are many. So as from my experience, what I did is we just restricted us to speed, feed and depth of cut. Apart from this, yes. So if my experience was there, I have done this. Yes, but how about the other participants? How generally people do it? Yes, so we have some literature surveys. Literature reviews or journal papers through which we know or they have done experimentations on many of the factors or the parameters. So through that, from the literature also, I can know that these are only the influencing parameters. And apart from that, if I want to study some or the other, I can add one or two factors, or I can just go with the flow, how many factors they are doing it. So that is one way of looking into the factors. So selection of factors is most important. Apart from that, now I have done with this response variable or the output, I selected the factors. But what are the levels that I am fixing up? For us, what I had levels was, for the first one was like how many persons can travel on a bike. I had 1 and 2 persons. Or the second one was a cc of an engine, like it is 100 and 150. The third one was average speed, that is 50 and around 70 that I took off. Yes, but what are the levels that I should fix? This is just for a bike mileage I have fixed up. But if it is like speed, feed, and depth of cut, what are the this? What are these values that how should I fix it up? So this fixing of these levels also is an important factor. Fixing of a level is an important thing. Okay, I shouldn't say factors, but factors are this thing. So what happens? How should I fix these levels? Like specific values of a factor that are input or continuous or discrete. You can have anything continuous or discrete. Usually we take continuous one. Okay. So how should I fix these factors? So in general, what makes it using one factor at a time, one factor at a time approach. Generally, we say this one factor at a time when we do initially, when we are starting from a scratch. When we don't know, or we are entering a new domain. So most of the researchers who are here are entering a new domain. So sometimes what there is, yes, from the literatures I can get something, but for my conditions, what I am doing in my laboratory, my machine is different and my output is different. Yes, my output may be same, but my machine is different, my material is different, and all this. So how should I do this? There comes one factor at a time. Usually one factor at a time. Danish sir, in the previous session, sir has introduced this one factor at a time. But yes, tomorrow afternoon, I'll be going through this one factor at a time and how we can fix the levels. Then we have to find what factors are most influencing. Once I know which are the factors most influencing, from there, again, I can go for the further further optimization also I can go through. So we will be looking into all these things in the coming up sessions. So the major issue like for us is when it comes to a design of experiments, each and every researcher till our experience, right, from our end, what we have looked into is, let it be any branch of engineering or any branch of research and studies, everywhere this problems comes up for each and every researcher, like what are the factors influencing or what are the levels that I should consider. So this actually is the most important aspect. So once you are okay with this and you know that what are the levels that I'm doing experimentation set and what are the factors that are influencing the output or the response, then you can choose any of the design from the design of experiments, like we have full factorial experiments, Taguchi experiments, or RSM experiment, RSM methods. These are some of the methods. So you can use any of these methods depending on what is the feasibility of the study, and we can study the output. Okay, we could interpret the output. Okay, so that is one way of looking into it. So the most problem where people face is this one. I don't know. Simply, I can't say that I have to select something from the researcher and this all things. Okay, let me take one example so that each and every person can get this clarity. So once I start machining, okay, or else I'll take an example of a machining where speed, feed, and depth of cut are the three influencing factors when it comes to machining. Okay, so each and every researcher will be having a material and he'll be machining it using these three factors. Okay, so what are these three factors? How will I select? So, okay, anyhow, I have selected these three factors, that is fine. I have directly selected these three factors, but what are the levels from which I should do machining? It's a very critical aspect. I'll be using some machine. Okay, I'll be using some, let us take a normal conventional lathe or a CNC lathe. Okay, you should know the capabilities of the lathe. Apart from that, let us go with this. We have some standard handbooks. Okay, we have some standard handbooks which will say that, for a certain material, like let us take in conal something 718 or something. Okay, just an example, it may not be the exact values what I'll be writing here. So if you see, if I take something like this, this is a nickel-based alloy, high-strength nickel-based alloy. So what does it say is, for this, V can be around 90 meters per minute to around 180 meters per minute. Okay, so this would be mentioned in the handbook, 90 meters per minute. This is some of the thing from the materials handbook. Then if you go for tooling, if you go for tooling from Kenna Metal or something, like if you take a TI ALN coated some solid carbide tools and something for machining. For this particular type of insert, he'll be mentioning that feed should be around 0.1 to 0.5 millimeter per revolution or something, millimeter per revolution, let me take this. And depth of cut would be like 0.1 to 0.3 millimeter. Okay, some things would be mentioned like this, right? So what is the difficulty? Why should I select the levels? Sir, you may be asking, sir, already this data handbook has given these values. Okay, this data from the data handbook and from the Kenna Metal browsers and all this, I got these values, then why shouldn't I select like 90 and 180 is 0.1 and 0.5, 0.1 and here feed is 0.1 and 0.5 and depth of cut is 0.1 and 0.3. Why shouldn't I do this? Yes, so what this data mean is, yes, you can machine Inconel 718 with cutting velocity of 90 to 180 meters per minute. That you can do it. But is it possible on your machine? Yes, I need to know that, is it possible on your machine? Most of our machines, we have to check the capability of our machines also. If you have a conventional lathe, at the maximum, how much should I go? How much can I go? Around 1200 RPM. Around 1200 RPM is the maximum RPM that I can go on my conventional lathe. Yes, you may be asking, yes, sir, I have, can't we do this? Why? Conventional, yes, some conventional lathes also you can do your experimentation, provided that you select correct levels. So some machines like don't have capability to go beyond 150 meters per minute. I don't have the capability of going more than 150 meters per minute. Feed also 0.5 millimeter per revolution is a very heavier thing. So like I had only 0.3 millimeter per revolution is the maximum thing I can go for feed. And depth of cut, yes, depth of cut, naturally most of us in general conventional also we go till 1 mm. So depth of cut is 0.1 to 0.3 I can take. So it shouldn't be a problem for me. So what I do is, usually, yes, if it is a normal lathe and normal turning operation, then these are the parameters and I do one factor at a time approach for all the levels so that I can know what approach, so that I can know actually what is the machine capability and I can fix the levels. Usually one factor at a time fixes these levels actually. Because we are trying to find out the engine, the machine capabilities or the tooling capabilities. And finally, with using one factor at a time, we'll be fixing up the levels. That is why one factor at a time is required. Okay. So, and it will be actually different for different different machines. If it let it be the same make also, depending on the life of the machine, these things vary. Now, that is why the machine capabilities vary. And make is a very like if the make changes of a machine, you can know how much parameters can change, right? With the same input, like same machine, same molder and all this, but still, the make changes the tools. Like if they're tight or if they're loose, depending on that also, sometimes you can't go to higher levels of this machine, or you can't go even lower levels also. Okay, so one factor at a time actually gives us this idea, and between which range can I do machining? So with this, we fix up some levels, okay? But yes, most of the researchers, if you go for any, like you can say in PhD, we have some seminars or something where they evaluate, they will be also asking you, how did you fix up these levels and all this? So that is where lies the foundation for design of experiments. So you have to fix up basically what levels you are doing, what are the factors which are influencing, and then they'll be looking into the output. So generally publishing papers and all these things, so we need to know. This thing is very necessary, and this will be dealing in coming up sessions. Apart from that, so these are response variables, factors, levels. Apart from that, replication. Yes. So what is replication? Right? Running or replication is nothing but doing the same experiment once again at the same levels. Doing the same experiment once again at the same levels. Why we have to do this? This thing is like, there are n number of errors which come up. If everyone is aware of, like, there are environmental errors, gross errors, and all these things which are coming up. Even the operator does a mistake. Even the material has some problem, then you don't have good this. Even the machine or the drives have some problems, so the output may vary. Even the operator while taking the readings has some problem. So these are all errors which come up. So how do you eliminate these errors? Yes, I can't go and sit and calibrate each and every machine or each and every process and do the experimentation, right? So what I should do? The easiest way of knowing that I have done the same, I have done a safe or a good work, or my output is reliable, is repeating it once again. Once I repeat the experiment once again, if I'm getting both the values in the nearby range, then I know that whatever the experimentation I have done is right enough. The value what I have noted is right enough. So replication is very important. So each and every experimentation, when you do or when we do, then it should be repeated once. Like for the mileage, like if you see for the mileage problem what we had taken earlier, in the mileage problem, I need to repeat it. Simply, I have just 1 liter, I have poured 1 liter petrol in the bike and I rode for until I finished that 1 liter. Is not dependable. Sometimes it may vary. If you in winter, you'll be getting one kind of mileage, in summer, you'll be getting one other kind of mileage. We can't rely. So what we do is we average it. Naturally, statistics people do it, right? So what we do is we always take the mean of the output. So you generally, what says at least 2 repetitions are required. If the second and the, if there is a huge difference between the first and the second repetition, then we have to take the third one. And then we have to see which 2 are the 2 closer ones. So we can take the average of the 2 closer values. So that is one more important aspect when it comes. Okay, next. Next one is called as interaction. Sorry. Next one is called as interaction. What is this interaction? So usually we were only speaking about like, yes, yeah. So we are only speaking about individual factors like speed and depth of cut, or in our case, number of persons, like a capacity of an engine, or average speed. We were only keeping in these factors. So the poll what we have done, I'll tell you, the poll what you have done, the 10 members who have already taken the poll, they have just seen if I ride a single ride or with a pillion, okay, the mileage, okay, with a single, it would be okay. So naturally what I said, then I'll see the second factor, that is capacity of an engine. Oh, 100cc and 150cc. So naturally I'll say that 150cc will give less mileage and 100cc will give more mileage. That is what is a normal perception what we do. Then we have the third one is 50, average speed is 50 and average speed is 70. So if it goes at a higher speed, then the mileage would be less. Yeah. So what has happened while polling is, we have seen each and every factor individually. Okay. So while polling, what we have done is we have seen each and every factor individually. But DOE, when it comes to DOE, it will see the interactions between 1, 2, and 3 factors, or speed, feed, and depth of cut, or let it be the number of persons, capacity of an engine, or an average speed. The interactions, it will look into. Is there any interaction? Which is more influential, or which 2 factors are influential? So if I say in that manner, then there is actually an interaction between these things, isn't it? Between 1 person and 2 person, 100 and 150, and the average speed is 70 and 50 and 70. There is actually an interaction. So what does interaction mean? Effect of one input parameter depends on the level of another input factor. Okay, so there is actually an influence. One, see, if I take this as output, there is an influence between this factor and this factor, isn't it? Or you can say this factor. So there is some interaction on the output. Okay, next. Now, as we have seen, what is response, what are factors, what are levels, how to fix up levels. Now let us go with the procedure, how basically we do it. First thing is set the objectives, that is the output, that is was our mileage or let it be MRR or the cutting forces. Okay, next, select the process variables means factors which are actually more influencing, that is speed, feed, depth of cut, or let it be the number of persons, capacity of an engine or something. Okay, we need to select this. Then select an experimental design. Once this thing is done, I need to select an experimental design which is very much adaptive for us. So most of us are fascinated about Taguchi, isn't it? Most of us are fascinated about Taguchi or RSM. Simply, if I'm using DOE, I'll be looking at, no, I will take RSM. Oh no, some people have suggested, no, my guide has suggested I'll take full factorial. No, some people say, my guide has suggested Taguchi, I'll use Taguchi. We can't force fit each and every design into any method. That is called as force fitting. So we shouldn't force fit. We need to understand the importance of that particular design. Then only we can do it. So this selection of experimental design would be carried out from tomorrow onwards, from tomorrow morning session onwards. This selection of experimental design will be carried out. Next, we need to execute this. Yes, I have taken that. That is, anyhow, through the DOE, I'll be having a walkthrough through the DOE. So the design is ready for us. Once I get the design, or we call it as a run order, we need to conduct the experiments in that. We need to place the data, that is output data, the data or the results, what I get into the output or the response tab. And there we need to execute the design. Okay, or then check the data are consistent with the experimental assumptions. Once that is done, then analyze and interpret the data. Analyzing and interpreting the data is, we need to know the ANOVA, how it is going on. There we'll interpret the data, which factor is more influential, how much is it influential on that, and then we'll be going with the presentation. So the beauty of DOE is most of the graphs required for publications can be taken directly from the DOE software. You can directly save it, and the same thing can be presented in a paper or a manuscript. You can directly insert it into a manuscript. So this is the most important thing. So instead of just, if you see how much our work is reduced, actually, when we go into the DOE software and then we see how much can we interpret, we can analyze and interpret, and the data is directly coming to us. Otherwise, if you go with the manual thing, you'll be having an Excel sheet. Then again, you'll be adding on the graphs, and you need to draw the graphs and all these things. Yes, if you want to combine two or more results, then yes, naturally you can get the data from the design software itself. The graph will be from the graph in the, presented in the DOE. You can get the data there, and you can draw it separately using some softwares like Origin or Excel. Also, you can use it. Okay, so this is the procedure for doing the DOE. Just a small glance I wanted to give you regarding this experimental design. Yes, so usually full factorial design, usually people say that it is a method which is done with all the combinations possible for your experimentation. Like if you see, what we had is three factors and two levels, isn't it? Three factors and two levels. So it was around eight experiment combinations. So if you are going for full factorial, you will usually do it with eight experimentation, or the full experimentation we do it. Then sometimes, if this is not possible, then we go for fractional factorial design. After that, screening designs like RSM, where still further the number of experimentations are reduced. And if you are not possible with the screening design also, we go for Taguchi methods. Yeah, please excuse me just. Yeah. So as I was telling you, right? That we get influenced by some of our friends or guides or the maybe the manuscripts that they have been, they'll be using something or else. It depends on what kind of experimentations we are using. If I can do the number of experiments, doing the experiments is much easier for me and I have all the facilities and the cost is less, then the best way of doing going through is the full factorial experiments, right? So this will give us the full insight of or you can utilize the DOE to a full extent using full factorial experiments. Sometimes what happens is there's some cost constraint or time constraint. Yes, somewhere I can compromise with some of the experiments and then I can go for fractional factorial experiment. This also Sir has already introduced you, but once we go to the software, I'll tell you this. Okay. So somewhere I just compromise with some of the run orders or some of the set of experiments, I can do full factorial, fractional factorial, that is okay. Then what happens is, after that, we call it as RSM, some other method like Bob CCD and Bob Cox methods. Yes, here what happens is, yes, here the search zone actually reduces. Search zone reduces and we can go for this experimentations. But this can be done only when you have much of an experience. You should know which factors are influencing, what are the levels which are much influencing, then only going for RSM will fetch some good results. Usually RSM, we call it as an alternate for optimization also. And we go for around second degree polynomial also. So that is like curve fitting, response surface method. So curve fitting also we can go through. And for this, means it is an optimum region actually, right? So optimum output when you want to get it, then you can go for this spinning designs. But initially we need one factor at a time. And full factorial experiments, usually full factorial gives us which factor is more influencing on the output. This too has to be done. This is for levels. This is for output. Once this thing is done, sometime, then you can go for RSM, right? Once the RSM is done, if it's required, it's fine. Otherwise, you can go for Taguchi method, where the cost of the experimentation is very high, time required for the experimentation is very high. So these are the conditions, or there is a scarcity of the machines or equipment. So we sometimes they don't allow us to run that long some of the experiments. So if that is the condition only, you need to go for Taguchi experiments. And Taguchi experiments, sometimes they won't give interactions also. So that is the biggest problem for Taguchi experiments. So we generally don't recommend Taguchi experiments until unless it's completely necessary. Because we don't know actually, sometimes we do very less experiments with Taguchi and we don't know actually which factor is influencing more on the output. So these are the biggest problems with Taguchi. So that's why we don't recommend for most of the times, but yes, until unless it's very necessary, where the experimentation is very costly and the facilities is very costly, and then getting the facilities very very tough, and apart from that, time consuming. Sometimes some experiments take 3 to 5 years. Sometimes some experiments take 2 to 3 months even. At that time, I can't rely on. I can't go for full factorial or all this kind of methods. I have to go for only Taguchi method. That is the case only where we go with Taguchi. Yes. So I hope each and every one has installed the software. So what my main intention would be when I go through the software is, how will you give some inputs or how will you select the different methods, and then how will you give some inputs? So this is where we'll be concentrating on the walk through the BOE software. So we'll be looking into factorial designs, Taguchi method, and response surface methodology. So before that, let us have a note of this thing, because this will be the factors that I'll be considering. These are the levels. Yes. And generally, this is the general information. Generally, we designate what set of experiments we are doing in this way, like 2^3. So this 2 represents the number of levels. That is the least number of levels. You can't do it at a single level. usually generally also we don't do it at a single level. For a single level, with normal experimentation only we have to do. And this one gives me the factor, the number of factors. Yes, you can go for 2 to the power of 2 factors also. So 2 to the power of 2 will lead around 4. That is the least thing, but for this thing we don't need a DOE. So generally we take 3 factors. Okay, so with this I would like to go through the walkthrough for the DOE software. I hope all the participants have installed the software by now, and so first thing is, let me close this up so that Dr. Varun sir, is my okay? So usually, generally, we get when we open the window. Yes, I have installed an older version of the Design of Expert, but the one we gave you link was Design Expert 12. Yes, no doubt the options are same. Yes, we have some advanced options in 12, but I couldn't do it because of my great antivirus. Okay, so generally, this kind of window is available for us. So for each and every window, like if you go to the file and you have a new design, so once you click the new design, you will be getting this kind of a window, and you'll be mentioning it will be like a factorial design. So generally, like if you see this design, as I told you, why that was important was this two, what is seen here will be the levels, and this three is the factors. So if you see on the y-axis we have the number of runs, and on the x-axis we have the number of factors. So for our experimental design, I'll be speaking about factorial design first. For our experimental design, we had two levels and three factors. For this is for the factorial design, so two levels and three factors. So what is happening here? Two levels and three factors. Next, let me continue. Okay, one second. I didn't give any replicates here. Replicates I can give two also here, right? Blocking I am not doing. Okay, so what then, this kind of window appears for me. So what are the name of the factors what I had? First one is number of persons. Next one was CC of engine. Third one is average speed. You can write the units also, because units is important. Why I am saying this thing is the graphs what you'll be getting will be directly on this unit. So the units you don't need to mention separately. A number of persons don't have any unit for it. A CC of engine, like I'll make it CC. Average speed is kilometer. Per hour. Then the levels, at what experimentations I am doing. Level, if you don't give anything, these are called as coded levels. So minus one and one directly it will take. I'm taking for two levels only, that's why. If it is a three level, minus one, zero, and one it will be. But anyhow, I have given this, so I'll go with 1 person, and here is 2 person. CC of engine was like 100 and 150. Average speed was 50 and 70. Participants, why I am giving this thing is, each and everything if you mention here, the graph what you get will be designated with the values of the inputs what you are giving directly. So you don't need to change it once again. So now if I continue the response, for me was mileage. Yeah, mileage, that is kilometers per liter. I had only one response. I'm only searching for one response. Yes, sometimes when you go for machine speed, depth of cut, if you see, you have cutting forces, you have surface roughness, you can have anything. So number of responses also can change. For time being, I am looking only for the mileage. So I'll be only concentrating on the mileage here. Yes. So what I had was, initially I have given two replicates, isn't it? So initially I have given two replicates. That is why if I go 2 to the power of 3, it is around 8 experiments that I should do. Generally, I should do 8 experiments. But I have given two replicates. That means the same set of values are repeated here. Okay. So before going to that, let me explain you what is this window actually. So usually we do experimentation to run order. So whatever the run order the DOE is giving you, you have to go through that run order. Or else I can go sort by standard order. Standard order, if I see, the run order will change. So this is the standard order. When you're representing the data, this kind of data in any of the journals, you have to represent through the standard order. But when you're experimenting, you have to experiment it through run order. Why we have to experiment through run order? There is always a myth, what you can say is, when you do the experiments repeatedly with the same frequency, your engine or you can move, just goes on, you just sets up, or your eyes also will set up. Like let us take, if I'm viewing some, or else like when you try to count the number of bogies in an goods train, this is the best way. When you try to count the number of bogies in a goods train, after is most probably like 50 to 60 wagons or we can call bogies, right? So they are attached in a goods train. So what happens is initially we'll be counting 1 to 10, 15, 20, we'll count it. But what happens is finally, once 20 or 30 are there, depending on your concentration, all the bogies will look like simultaneous for us, okay, or continuous for us. Then we can't differentiate the difference between them. So in the same way, in machining also, what we do, machining or any other experimentation, we don't go in that progressive, we go in a different way. Okay, so first we take this somewhere, if you see, in the first experimentation, I have taken 2%, 100 cc and average speed is 50. The next what I did is, I am not going with 100 cc bike, I am going with 150 cc bike and 1% and 50 average speed. The third one, yes, I am going, what I am doing here, I am going with 2%, 150 and the average speed has changed. The third one, 1%, so here it is repeated. If you can see this one, second one and the fourth one are repeated. Okay, so this is why we call it as replications, or else what I can do is without replication also we can do. So without replication also we can do, so that it is much easier for us to understand. So what I, sorry for this. So what I do is replications, one I'll write it down. So usually without replications, what I'll be getting is eight number of runs. So what I'm doing is each and every time when I go with the run order, these things are changing. So usually it's a best practice to do the experimentation through run order. So what I'll do is now with this first run order, one number of person of one, capacitor engine is 150 and average speed is 70. For this, I'll do some experimentation. I'll write some mileage here, whatever I get it from the test. Okay. And for the second level, 150 and 70, I'll do the experimentation, write it down here. So once these things are done, we go for analyzing. Anyhow, I have not inputted data. This is just a walkthrough, and you need to. I just wanted to show you how you give an input data. So once this thing is done, you can go with a summary. You can see here, it is called as factorial. Which kind of study you are doing is factorial. Number of runs are 8. Initial design is 2-level factorial. And these are the data. So which actually these are coded and these are uncoded. Low actual, high actual is 1 and 2. These are actual and these are coded ones. So you can just verify whatever you have done, whatever you have given as an input is right. Okay. So that is what we can do till now. Okay. So this is for factorial design. Next, let us go for a new design. I don't want to save anything. So this was factorial design. So now sir has told you also the fractional factorial design. So what does fractional factorial design mean? So if you're seen here in this diagonal thing, 2 to the power of 2, 2 to the power of 3, 2 to the power of 4, 5, and so on, see, these are all full factorial. All these things what you can find in white is actually full factorial. So let us go with this. What I'm doing is with this is a fractional factorial. I want to conduct less number of runs with more number of factors. Let us assume one thing. With 8 number of runs, I'll be considering 4 factors. Why can't I do this way? Yes, I can do this way, right? Okay, so I can do this way. That is what is called as a fractional factorial, or else like 2 to the power of 5. So what does this mean is, with 5 factors, I can analyze 5 factors with just 16 runs. Okay, so what does this thing, let us go with this one itself, which we are known to. 2 to the power of 3, 8 factors, I am analyzing with 8 runs, I am analyzing 3 factors. Okay, at the same time with 8 runs, I can analyze 4 factors. So with the same number of experiments, if I can analyze more factors, it is advantageous for me, right? So that is why fractional factorial is also important sometimes. Now 2 to the power of 4, how much it would be like? It would be around 16 runs. So with the 16 runs, I am analyzing 4 factors actually, if I speak with full factorial. But at the same time, with the 16 runs, I can analyze 5 factors also. That is called as fractional factorial. So generally these green ones which are there can be used or can be used as a fractional factorial and can be relied on. Yellow ones are there which are okay intermediate. If you're comfortable only, you can use this yellow ones or the factors or the you can call the design or this yellow one. But strongly these red ones are not recommended. Okay. Strongly these red ones are not recommended. You can assume with 8 runs, I can do 7 factors. Then you can assume what would be the output and how much can you rely on this output. Okay, so that is regarding the fractional factorial designs. Now, full factorial, fractional factorial is over. Taguchi is one. Let us go with this Taguchi. So usually what happens with Taguchi is, with Taguchi we do the least number of experiments. Okay. With Taguchi, we do the least number of experiments. There is always a restriction with Taguchi that we need to check actually which one is more influencing and which one is less influencing, and which kind of design we need to select. It's an important aspect for us. So if you see Taguchi and in this Design Expert 12, it is very much clearer than in Design Expert 7 actually. So let us go with this Taguchi. So usually Taguchi means L4, like L4 will be having L8, L9, L12, L16, L16, L18, and L27, and so on will be having it around. L64 will be having a number of designs available. So what we have to look into is, how many levels are you having? And how many factors you are considering? Apart from the levels and the factors that you are looking into, how many are categorical factors and how many are numerical factors, isn't it? So that we have to keep in mind. So usually when you go for two-level designs, what you have, L4 you have, sorry, L4 you have, L8 you have, L12, L16, then L32 also is not possible for us. L64 is possible for us. Okay, so that is one way. Apart from that, how many factors I am looking into? If I am looking into 3 factors and 2 levels, then I can go for L4. L8 is 2 factors and 7 levels. L9 is 3 factors and 4 levels. L12 is 2 factors and 2 levels and 11 factors. So why I am saying this thing is, sometimes you don't have the feasibility to do most of the things. For us, like let us take L9. Two levels and 3 factors. for us, two levels and three factors, it was much easier for you, for us, and I can go directly with this, two levels and three factors, and I can give your mileage, and I can continue. Yeah, so this was okay for me, isn't it? So they are already coded once, so it is okay for us. And A, you know what is a factor, and B, you know what is a thing. Okay, actually, this is an older version of me. Otherwise, you can just edit info here, and you can keep it like a number of persons. And what was the unit? We don't have it. Two levels. Okay. Number of levels are two. And we keep it okay. And this one was, for us, it was like CC of engine. I'll keep it as CC. Two levels. Yes, if you want to modify this, yes, let us see if we can modify. Yes, but in Design Expert 12, it is the feasibilities are more. Here, the feasibility is a bit less when it comes to Design Expert 7. Again, the last one is average speed. And I can do these things. Okay, so I can give some units also. And the response also, I can give some units. Okay, so with this, I can give, with this, if I can conduct some experiments, I can do this. So what I meant to say is, for the same thing, what we have used with full factorial, there we had around 8 experiments to be conducted. In here, we have around 4 experiments only. So with 4 experiments, we are conducting the same things. So almost 50% we have reduced the number of experimentations and number of, this, what you can say is the number of runs, and then we are analyzing it. So you can assume, right, with the less data, we are getting more results. But usually, Taguchi, we don't prefer when it comes. So usually, we try to look at full factorial designs only. Okay, so I'll go for the new design here. And okay, I'll go for the new design. Apart from this, we have L9 and L12. Actually, if you see, L4 means, this 4 means number of runs which are there. L8 means number of runs. L9 means number of runs. So this actually designated the number of runs. So with this directly, you can get the number of runs. Apart from that, why I'm showing you this L9 is, sometimes I don't have this fourth factor. I was only doing with the 3 factor. So generally, what we do is we try to delete this thing, and directly we can go for the mileage test like this. We also, we can do it, but this is the possibility, and this is when it goes, when the number of factors goes on increasing, there we have to first identify which factor is most influential and all this, and depending on that only I need to delete that factor. So simply directly I can't delete it. This is just for showing you how I should do it, or to show you how it can be done. That's why I have done this. Okay, so this was regarding Taguchi method. This was regarding Taguchi method. So you can use any of these designs depending on that. Apart from that, as we, I didn't tell you regarding this L18. So this is like a categorical factor, like something which I can't vary. In our, like some values are there which I can't vary, or which doesn't have any numerical values, like the number of persons I was using, 1 and 2 is a categorical factor actually. Okay, but for example, I just showed you that, but yes, still, if I want to use some categorical factors, like when you go for machining, there are 2 type of metals that I'm using, maybe one is inconel and one is titanium or something, then I can use this categorical factor also. Okay, the last one which we'll be looking into is response surface. So most of us, the researchers are like into response surface. So we have both 2 things, central composite design and box Mencken designs. So central composite design and box Mencken designs are here. And usually let us go with central composite design. So the values that you have, when you once you click on the central composite design, the same inputs you need to give here, number of number of persons. You don't have any unit there, then CC or engine. Or you can write engine capacity, like it is at CC. And the third one is like average speed. Average speed is in kilometers per hour. Yes, here you can give the values also, 1 and 2. CC of an engine was 100 and this is 150. And average speed is like 50 and 70. Okay. So once I have done this, two levels, I used only two levels. Usually what happens is in RSM, the center level it is taking by itself. So once let us go there and check this. Mileage is in kilometers per liter. So what has happened here is, as I told you, in RSM, we can take it as ECD or Bob Rankine design, at least you should need three levels. Okay, yes, you can go for three factors or two factors also, but at least what you need is three levels. Otherwise, it will take it by itself. Okay, so number of persons is 2, 1, 2, and 1.5. From where should I bring 1.5? Yes, you can tell me that you can carry a kid half the weight of the two persons, but yes, practically sometimes it's not possible. So you need to have a three level design. Once you have a three level design only, then it's possible to go with RSM. So usually three level designs are recommended. So you should have a three level design here. Apart from three levels, or five levels also, where alpha value is considered, but I didn't consider here the alpha value. Alpha value is going beyond this or under this values, under this levels. But when we go with RSM, we'll be considering that. Okay, so please try to remember that once it is like, once you select RSM, minimum three level experimentation, you have to do it. We can't do it with two level experimentation. That is the only restriction. Apart from that, tomorrow, like when in the other coming up sessions, we'll be looking into some of the things like where you can use central composite design or Box Rankine design. So with the same set of parameters, I don't know how many of you noted down. We had how many runs here? We had around 19 runs for the same set of parameters. Now let us go for new design. And I'll be using the previous data. I'll be going for Box Rankine. Box Rankine for the same values. And if I say the number of runs have been reduced to 17. This we'll be looking into when we have a session on RSM and why Box Rankine we are reducing things. But for most of the studies when we see CCD designs are actually most central composite design are mostly most recommendable. And with for branches like, yes, mechanical have some problems, we can't go values beyond or something, but when it comes to chemical or chemistry or some other branches, like they can go beyond the like values. Like if I say machining parameters, if I want to go beyond, I can't go beyond that because the machine has a restriction there. But when it goes to for reactions or chemical or some other branches, they don't have restriction. They can mix something if there's a mixture kind of thing. And like if I go for some polymers also, when we do polymers also, in mechanical we do polymers also. So when you go for polymers, there it is a difference. Right? I can mix something more, right? If some additive is there, then I can mix some other quantity or less quantity or more quantity there. So there, this kind of designs work wonders actually. Okay, so for going beyond that, I need to use some alphas here. If I use some alpha values beyond this and beyond that, then depending on the alpha value, we'll be having the central composite three times of central composite designs. So that we'll be looking into the coming up sessions. And this is the Box Rankine design. So both are same, but both approaches are different actually. So Box CCD is the points will be at the corners, but Box Rankine we have it at the center. So things will be different a bit from both of this. So I hope with this we are done with the walkthrough of the software, and these are the things where you get, most of us face some problems of giving inputs and these things. If anyone has any doubt regarding the present sessions, please you can ask us regarding today's walkthrough, and any general discussions that if you are having some facing some problems for doing experimentations and all these things. So I request our coordinator, Dr. A. Varun.
Yes, sir.
I didn't see my videos off. So I request the coordinator to please address the participants, and if any participants have any kind of doubt, so that we can just clear it off. And we have some time here, so that.
Sir, so the main query that was raised by most of the thing is like, trial version is for academic purpose, because it is normally a trial version for educational institutes. So normally educational institutes will have something at the rate, no, we have at BVR-IT in the similar sense, it is expected. This is nothing to address from our end. So I'm sorry, we cannot have any other option. But there is another option that you can try, that is, and there are other similar softwares available out there. One is Minitab, which you can go check it out. It is also very similar, very popular, and it is also worth considering. Similarly, JMP, SAS are other two packages which are also equally good. JMP is little advanced, SAS is also little advanced. Minitab and Design Expert, the one which we are trying to install it, both are one and the same. So if you can try and install Minitab, even that is fine. So I think many of you who are in the field, they may also recognize, and they may also suggest few other. Okay. Yeah, please do that, sir. I think that should be able to install, like Minitab should work for you. That's what I can suggest. And even I am not sure about Ubuntu, because Mac it's possible, but Ubuntu I'm not sure. Even for Ubuntu, you may try the other alternatives, which are which is this one, Minitab. So apart from this, if you have any queries, please you may ask, post your questions in the chat window, or you may directly unmute and you may ask the question, please.
Yeah, dear participant, there isn't any language barrier, so please you can ask in Hindi also, we have no problem. So most there, but it's okay. We are
okay, if that is the case, then okay. All right. So we will come to the end of day one of afternoon session. And I thank Dr. Sandeep for taking up this session, and he has given us a walkthrough to the entire Design Expert package software. And there was a few examples which I think many of you who have taken it to from the foundation level, just to lift it from the ground level, this example will help us, because when we normally take mileage into consideration, many of the time we may feel like there is only a few parameters that may influence, like how you write. Hello, is my voice audible? Okay.
Yes, it's audible.
Okay. So that may be the only cause that may be under the impression. But once you start exploring, you will find that for each and every scenario, you may have to explore the parameters, and that's how you'll arrive at the final solution. And when in the morning session also, you might have seen Dhani sir was explaining about so many different types of case studies which can be taken up. Now, when we start thinking or looking at these things differently, you will try to, you will identify so many experimentations that can be performed, and you will come to an optimum solution. So that is where we also would like the young researchers to look in that direction. So I once again thank all the participants who have joined here, and I thank Dr. Sandeep for this wonderful session. And the feedback link will be shared through WhatsApp, and we will have tomorrow day 2 session, and tomorrow's session will be very interesting because Dinesh sir from IIT Palakkad is going to talk about ANOVA analysis, analysis of variance. It is a very important analysis, statistical method from which we'll come to know which parameters is most contributing. So I hope all the participants will join on time 10 o'clock with the same URL. Thank you, everyone.